Hey guys, thanks for watching. Okay, I'm gonna show you guys out of my clutch how I do my face. So I'm gonna do a daytime look and a daytime look. So right now I'm using my clutch, and inside my clutch I have about 9 shades. So right now I'm using my contour, believe it or not, for my eyebrow. So I'm just taking an angles brush. We have one, it's called Know Your Angles. And you can just honestly put your eyebrows on so smooth. It kind of acts as a pomade, and it just makes it such a perfect color shade. I mean, we have so many different contour colors to choose from, so you can get almost a perfect match to your eyebrows. And so next I'm going to show you out of my clutch. This is what I have. I'm working out of 9 shades, and it's basically my purse, you guys. I take this everywhere with me. So I'm going to use my 30-second hack brush. This is the double-ended brush. You might have gotten this one or the detail hack. But what I like to do is I start to stipple in small stippling little stroking motions. And the shade I'm using right now is amber, just to give my under eyes a smoother, more neutral color. And then I'm going to go in with Aura right now to brighten. I feel like everybody has 2 shades of highlights, so if you were recommended 2 shades, then great. It's just gonna be better that way. So right now I'm gonna take Aura and kind of just go in a triangle shape under my eyes, a big one, a big triangle shape. I will go on my eyelids, on my forehead, and kind of fan it out. And you see how it just draws and attracts that light onto your face. That's why it's called a highlight. It's so awesome. So it covers redness amazing. Do you see how well it's covering my redness? And I will go over my lips just because I feel like my lips are always so super red, and I really like to just give them that extra foundation to make sure that when I do go put my lip color on, it will pop. So I'm gonna go up my jaw, but I'm gonna kind of stay away from like underneath my cheekbone because I'm going to be putting my contour there. So just going around, making sure I have an even foundation and get rid of all that redness. Now I'm going to go in with the same side into the contour, under my cheekbone. So you'll feel there's a cheekbone kind of like at the start of your ear, and you press down, you'll feel it right underneath. That's where you want to create your shadow with your contour. So you can also minimize your forehead if you have a larger forehead. This will help it look smaller. Also attract people to looking into your eyes. So you want to take that contour into your jaw to kind of chisel out your neck area and give you more of a shadow and depth there, so your face kind of looks more chiseled. I love that look. So I'm going to take a little more of that Aura onto the other side of the brush to kind of soften the edges of the contour. So I'm just going to blend it all out kind of with that end, and it makes a nice smooth finish. So I'm going to take my 30-second hack brush, pinch it into my contour, and go down the side of my nose to create a more even-shaped nose. So here I go, just blending around. I'm just going to do small circular motions underneath, and then do that on the other side. And this is just going to really blend and press into my skin, and I love it. Okay, so now I'm going to use my blush. I can show you with the brush how airbrushed look it can give you. But if I use my finger, you'll see how pigmented the blush actually really is. So be careful with the blush because it's so strong, but it's your best friend because it adds so much color and life to your face. And I absolutely love it. I cannot go a day without wearing my blush. And it also goes for a lip and cheek, but I will show you that in a second. So just take your 30-second hack brush, same side, and just blend it out. If you're wondering if the colors are ever going to blend or mesh together and ruin what your look, it doesn't do that at all. In fact, the brush applies the right amount of foundation, and you're able to use it. So now moving on to my lips, I'm going to go ahead and use Plum, Sandstone, and Desert Sunset to create the perfect, I want to call it the perfect nude for me. It's a really pretty soft pink, and I love to take my contour right here to make my lips stand out. So just take your angles brush and go right at the seam and the edge of your lips and outline them And then you're gonna take your finger and blend those colors in. It gives your lips the prettiest pop. Take your illuminator, my color is Dream, the top of your cheekbones, and anywhere you wanna have that light shine and kind of give you a little shimmer. I think this gives you a really youthful look. Doesn't matter what age you are, you can sport it. So wear that illuminator. It is so pretty and it's right there in your beauty foundation. So that is my look. I'm excited. Here is the Stay Spray. This is what helps your makeup stay on really well all throughout the day. I take it in my Perfector sponge and I'll use my sponge to apply it. But the sponge is also pressing in everything together and making a flawless finish. So let's move on to eyeshadow. I have a little small palette of my favorite shadows. I'm gonna take this eyeshadow everything brush and you are going to see how fast I can put an eyeshadow look together. So I'm gonna take my eyeshadow everything brush, going into a creamy color to set my cream foundation because I used the highlight as a foundation on my lips. So flip that brush over and you can go into a medium shade right underneath the lash line. I love doing this because it really makes your eyes pop and it gives them dimension. So if you flip it over, you can go into another medium shade. This is called Lullaby, and I will just kind of press that into the corners of my eye, and then I'm gonna flip the brush over and go into Lullaby, and kind of smoke out Lullaby into my crease, and kind of just all over my lip. But do you see with back and forth windshield wiper motions, you can get the most flawless eyeshadow look with this brush. It's so fast. I swear I save so much time with this brush. So I'm just gonna do the same thing on that side. Windshield wiper motions back and forth. And then I'm gonna get my darkest shade of all called Coal with the other end. And I'm gonna give my eyes a pop of like dark depth just to warm them up. This can be a date night look right here. All you have to do is add that Coal to the bottom lash on the top and the bottom lash on the very, very bottom, and it's going to give you such a pretty smoky effect. Here we go. So just add a little Coal to that bottom corner, and there you have it. It's so beautiful. So just remember, always top it with some mascara. Now, if you wanna really bronze this up and get full coverage, just take your B-squared brush, go into your Bella bronzer. It's a cream bronzer. I absolutely love Bella bronzer. I mean, it takes your look from one, you know, kind of like a fall look where your skin is looking a little on the pale side to like a summer sunset glow. It is just a beautiful bronzer and it goes on any skin tone. So I'll flip my brush over and I'm gonna add a little extra blush to warmen my face up just a little more so I can have more of a dark date night look. And I'm gonna actually take this detail hack brush to give myself a little more full coverage under my eyes and a little more brightness so that way it really does look like a complete date night. And I can also take the contour and go a little warmer too with my contour. When I say warmer, I just mean a little more heavier. So you're going from a daytime look to a nighttime look. So I'll take the detail hack brush, and I love this brush because I can get into my contour and make it real defined. So if you do not have this brush, definitely recommend getting the detail hack brush. Watch me use my contour with the small side. I like to kind of create this like half moon underneath my cheek to give my cheekbone a lift and depth. So when I smile, you will see my cheeks completely lifted and it's just so pretty. Anybody, this will look good on anybody, just a half moon shape right there. And then you blend it out the other side, pushing it up, and then take your Perfector sponge and just make sure you blend everything together. And it's pretty much that simple. I really love the detail hack brush to give you a really pretty date night look. A little more illuminator just to go a little heavier. Can't go wrong with that. Tops of your cheeks, on your nose, and your lips. And that's it, guys. This is my daytime and date night look. And you can do it too. If you need extra colors, just message your artist.